Now listen here. A tower stands vertically on the ground. A tower stands vertically on the ground. Here you see. But in the exam you can't draw this tower and all. Just you have to draw a line like this. This is tower. This is tower. A tower stands vertically on the ground. So, where is the ground? Here is the ground. So, this is ground. From a point on the ground, from the point on the ground, which is 48 meter away from the foot of the tower. Where is the foot? Here is the foot of the tower. From the foot of the tower, how many meters away? 48 meters away. The point. From a point on the ground, which is 48 meter away from the foot of the tower. You have to understand the concept and draw the diagram. Then the angle of elevation. What is given? Elevation. The angle of elevation of the top of the tower. Where is the top? This is top. This is the top of the tower. The angle of elevation of the top of the tower is 30 degree. So, first you should know what is meant by elevation. So, here 30 degree. How I drew this? Just you see the definition. The angle of elevation is an angle formed by the line of sight. This is the line of sight here. This is the line of sight because from this point you are looking at the top of the tower. Looking at the top. So, the angle formed by the line of the sight with the horizontal. So, the angle between the horizontal and the line of sight. It is nothing but the angle between the horizontal and the line of sight. But the condition is there. What? When the point is being viewed is above the horizontal level. The point should be above the horizontal level. This is the must. Above the horizontal level. So, this is the angle between the horizontal and the line of sight. But the point where it should be above the horizontal level. So, the angle of elevation is nothing but the angle formed by the line of sight with the horizontal. When the point is above the horizontal level, being viewed, it is not necessary for the definition. When the point is above the horizontal level, just I am shortening the definition for the late bloomers. That's all. So, this sentence very well you know. The angle formed by the line of sight with the horizontal line. Just you divide it into two parts. When the point is above the horizontal level. Why we are saying that in that case we raise our head to look at the project. This is not necessary for the definition. So the angle formed by the line of the sight with the horizontal. Because for elevation and depression also both are same. But here there is a definition. Here it makes the difference. When the point is viewed is above the horizontal level. So that only I draw the line here. So because this is the horizontal level, we are seeing above the horizontal. So this is 30 degree. What they are asking you to find out, find the height of the tower. Height of the tower, H. So here it is right angled triangle. Because in the book it is given, just I paste the picture here. But in the exam you will be able to draw like this. If you want to name the vertex also, you can name the vertices. But it is not necessary according to me. But first what you want to find out, H. What is the measurement given here, 48. So what theta you will be able to form here. So theta is here, 30 degree. What is the side opposite to theta? Opposite side. This is opposite side. 48 meter is nothing but adjacent side. So opposite by adjacent means what theta that is? Tan theta. Tan theta equal to opposite by adjacent. Here theta's measurement is what? What it is given? 30 degree. Tan 30 equal to opposite is nothing but H. Adjacent is nothing but 48. 8. So you should know the value. I taught you the palm trick, isn't it? With the help of your hand, you can find out the values. Here 0, 30, 45, 60, 90. But 90 and 0, it is not necessary here. Only 30, 45, 60. A small trick I'll tell you. 1 by root 3. This you should remember because 30 means 3, related with 3 only. So root 3, 1 by root 3. For 45, you give 1. This root 3, you give it to 60 degree. That's all. So 1 by root 3, if you remember, you can remember all these 3 values. 1 by root 3, tan 30 is 1 by root 3, tan 45 is 1, tan 60 is root 3. Here tan 30. So 1 by root 3 equal to h by 48. So here what you should do, you want to find out h. So this 48 divided 48, when it goes to other side, multiplication. So 48 divided by root 3. Understand? So what you should do, you are going to multiply the denominator and numerator by root 3. So what will you get? 48 root 3 divided by root 3 into root 3, 3 equal to h. 1, 3 is 3. 1, 3 is 3. 6, 3 is 18. So 16 root 3 meter equal to h. H is equal to 16 root 3. Don't forget to write the unit. Do you follow? What it is given? 48 meter. So 16 root 3 meter. If you want to give the name also, you can give. Instead of opposite by adjacent, what can you write? PQ by QR. Otherwise RQ. Then in the PQ, in the place of PQ, you are substituting H. In the place of QR, you are substituting 48. That's all. But it is better because it will take time while you are giving name and all. So that only just I taught you like this. If you want to name it and write, you can write it. Do you follow? First, you should know what is meant by elevation. Above the horizontal level. Do you follow?